Thank you for working with American Radon Mitigation. Let's take a look at how your new mitigation system works. So let's start at the top. We've got the radon system alarm. Yours may vary, but this is the most popular one at this time. This alarm can be tested by pushing the test button. And then all these four different lights mean something different, and that's written on the side of the alarm here. It's also in the owner's manual for the alarm in the system packet. There's a hush feature, which you can use to silence the alarm. Let's say your system freezes up for several days, or you lose power for several days, or the fan is off. You may have to recalibrate your alarm. To do so, you're going to push in on the cover and then slide down to gain access to the battery. Then remove the battery, and you're going to push and hold this test button to discharge any power that's remaining inside the alarm. Hold this for about 10 or 15, 20 seconds, and then reinsert the battery. It'll go through a calibration cycle, which takes about 20 seconds, and you'll hear a chirp, and then it'll go back to sensing, where you'll see the green LED flash about every minute or so. Going down from the alarm, we've got the U2 manometer. So this is not measuring your radon levels. This is showing that there is suction. It's measuring whether the fan is working or not. It's just a visual gauge. If the fluid levels are offset or different, that's good. It means the radon system is working to create suction underneath your home, thereby reducing your radon levels. If the fluid level is equal, that would mean the radon system is not working to create suction. Here we've got the radon system label. So that's got our information at the top, including our phone number. Here it's got a label that says, or a sticker that says, call for service if the fluid levels change drastically from what was initially marked on here. So in this instance, we have 0.5 inches was the initial YouTube reading written on the side here. We've also got the fan make and the operating cost. We've got the post-mitigation levels here, and once you get your pre-mitigation levels here, once you get your post-mitigation test results back, you can write them here. We also recommend that you print off the report that you get and put the radon test results in the packet so that you can find them in the future. Here we've got your system operating packet. So this is just some important information about your radon system. It's got the ongoing maintenance and monitoring, and then it's got our card here as well. Also the PFE or pressure field extension information that we wrote down is included in this packet as well. Now let's go take a look at some of the other things to keep an eye on. If your home has a sump basket or a sump pump, you may have a cover that looks like this one, or you may have a clear Lexan cover. Either way, to gain access to the sump basket, you will simply remove the access port by loosening the red nut, and you can pull out the access port. This will allow you to reach down and test your sump pump or visually inspect how high the water level is in your sump basket. It's important that you tighten this nut back up because this is forming an airtight seal, and we do have the cover sealed with silicone as well. So if you ever take the cover off, say to replace a sump pump, make sure that is sealed when that job is complete. Here we've got a wire going up to our water alarm, and there's a sensor down in the sump basket that when the water touches that sensor, say if the sump pump has failed, or in this case we don't have a sump pump, the water gets too high where it's about to flood the basement, it's going to set off this alarm. You can test this alarm by hitting the button on the side here. It's a test reset button. And here we've got the instructions for this alarm. This alarm is operated by a 9-volt battery. So you'll simply slide it up to take it off the wall and then depress this cover and slide it down to gain access to the battery. There is a low battery chirp where it'll chirp every 5 minutes when it's time to replace that battery. In this home, the radon system comes up the basement wall, out into the garage, up the garage wall, into the attic where the radon fan is, and then discharges out through the roof. Your home may have the radon system running through a closet into the house attic, or it might have an outside radon system. If you have an outside system, the fan is going to be located on the side of your house and may have a heat cable system. If you have a heat cable system, you want to turn that on when it's cold, when the system is susceptible to freeze up, and then shut that off when the system is not needed to keep the radon system clear. If you have the heat cable, we will leave the wiring kit for the electrician with your radon test kits. So make sure you keep this and give it to them when they come to wire your radon fan and heat cable. Here we've got your customer satisfaction survey. So if you could fill this out, let us know how we did, how we can do better. We'd appreciate that. We've also got a prepaid envelope where you can mail that back to us. Here you've got an air check radon test kit. This is a short-term radon test to see how the radon system's working after mitigation. You can set this up 24 hours after the system's been up and running. We'll include a link in the description to a video where I explain exactly how to set this up. We'll also put that video here. If you have multiple radon test kits that we left behind, it may mean that your house has multiple foundation zones. So you want to set one of these test kits in each foundation zone. So four level split, for example, you're going to set one down in the lowest level and then one on that other foundation zone. Or a house with a crawl space, test the basement and then the room above the crawl space. I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thank you so much for working with us.